Hi, I'm Rachel Gower. Welcome to the Beauty Breakdown. Today, stylist and makeup artist Trish Lecourias from The Upper Hand will give us the breakdown on how to look young with makeup in one of our most popular Mirror Mirror segments.
Make any woman look old at any age is too much shimmer. We're going to show you different ways to look younger when it comes to your makeup.
Makeup can really age you. If you put it on right, it will be the most flattering thing to your face and actually take years off. If you put it on wrong, it can really add years and take away from your fabulous features.
The first step to looking young 101 is to try not to look younger than you should. And shimmer does just that for every woman.
Shimmer equals glitter. And if you're over about 23, you should probably eliminate that. Sheen, however, is a youthful look. And the reason for the sheen is to make it look like your skin is sort of glowing from within.
Along with sheen, there are other tips on the makeup scene that can help all women look pristine. We're taking years off of five women today just by changing their makeup. First up is Sherry.
Sherry has on way too much eye makeup, and it's making her look harsh and old. She also has on the wrong color foundation. You can see the line between her cheeks and her neck. And her lip liner does not match her lip color. The way that Sherry had her makeup done made her look old. It draws attention to every single one of her features. It shows every single line in her face, and it's just too much. She's a great case of less would be a lot more.
When applying foundation, apply sparingly and make sure it matches. When it comes to eye color, salon owner Rachel Gower says a charcoal eye color can work.
Dark is okay, you just have to do dark right. And for Sherry, this was the right contour color.
When it comes to lashes, go for length, not density. And for the lips, always make sure your liner and lip color match. And the results?
She looks 10 years younger.
Kim also has some makeup sins.
Kim has a very youthful face. She was actually making herself look older by not having a well-defined brow, doing a little bit too much eye makeup. She wasn't getting any kind of contour in her cheeks, and she had on a lip color that really had like this purple undertone. It kind of made her look washed out.
The first step to taking years off Kim's appearance, cleaning up her brows.
If your brows are the right shape, it's like a non-surgical facelift. It is the easiest, fastest, cheapest way to lift your entire face up.
And after some threading and trimming.
They're beautiful. Oh my God, Phoebe, I think we'll get married. This is beautiful. Oh my God. They look so clean.
Kim has a nice full face, but it looks really nice to have a little bit of contour. So Trish used a contouring method using a highlighter and a blush to give her a little bit more cheekbone.
Use the highlighter to create a 7 on each cheek, and then add blush inside the 7 for a perfect contour.
When it comes to lips, you need to remember that you need to wear what looks good on you. Don't worry about what's going on the runway, because it's not real. You can almost never go wrong with a light pink, something in the pink family, or even a light pinkish red.
Go for glosses and opaques, and stay away from dark, harsh, and matte lip color.
Jessica's brows are too light, and they're not the right shape for her face. One of the things that ages you most is a thin brow. A thicker brow implies health, which implies youth. If you're blonde, you want your brows to be a shade or two darker than your hair. And if you're brunette, you want them to be a shade or two lighter. There's so many ways to fix your brow. If you do not have enough brow to work with, there are many ways around that. You can tint the brow to put the color back in, and that might be enough. If it's not, you can also use pencils, brow gels, brow mascaras, to add a little bit more to your brow.
Stencils are also available to help you find the perfect arch and also to use as a lead. To make her eyes more defined, we tint her lashes and finish up with some eyeliner.
One of the tricks with eyeliner to keep it from looking too heavy is to start on the outer corner of the eye and use very small, very thin strokes moving inward. And you want to go to about right the inner side of where your eye color starts.
And with Jessica's more defined eyes and brows, 30 looks forever away.
Penny's a beautiful woman. Here's what she's doing wrong. Her eyes are already close set, So she was using too much dark shadow, which is making them look smaller and closer together. Her cheeks had too much contour, too much blush. And then also, she was matching her lip color to her hair color, and that's a no-no. Penny ended up with a look that was too dark and too intense, drawing attention to flaws on her face. Trish lightened up her entire look. She used lighter colors on the eyes to draw her eyes out. She used a much lighter cheek color, and she used a lighter lip color.
When it comes to lips, a good rule of thumb is to use a lip liner that's either the exact color of your lips or two shades lighter. Ditch the dark.
So Penny looked really dark and almost vampy before, and after, she looks light and beautiful and much more feminine, which equals young and hot. Tanya had a real chalky, ashy, pale look to her foundation, so she was missing the dewiness and the glow that she could have. She also had way too much blush on, and that made that look even worse. The first thing we did with Tanya was add a really nice moisturizing primer, and then we put a very sheer powder on.
A contoured cheek is good, but not if it's too dark. Choose a light color that complements your skin tone.
Also with Tanya, we added very subtle eyeliner and light eye makeup, and we gave her nice long lashes. So it's just enough to make her best feature stand out. There's one more step that will really give her the dewy look, and it's great for skin that's a little bit older. Trish is gonna spritz a hydration spray right on top, very lightly, and it will lock in the makeup and set it, and also give her the dewy look the whole day long.
But to really achieve that dewy look,
the best makeup is always gonna start with the best skincare. So use a great cleanser, use something to replenish your skin at night, protect it during the day. If you start with that, your makeup will look so much better. So when it comes to taking years off your face, the best facelift and the cheapest facelift you can ever get is adjusting your makeup.
For more makeup tips to take years off, go to livewellhd.com.